Hi everyone, Bethany Times Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it's time for a review of the new Kelly Lee Owens record, Inner Song. This is the sophomore full-length LP of Welsh electronic musician Kelly Lee Owens. Curiosity kind of got the better of me with it because I was getting so many requests to talk about it. On top of that, there were some tracks from her breakthrough debut in 2017 that I saw a lot of potential in. So I went into this LP wondering if her unique combination of techno, house, new age, and ambient pop would take a stronger shape this time around. The 10 tracks and 50 minutes of material I found vary pretty greatly in terms of style, tone, quality, to the point where it's almost hard to believe that it's all coming from the same artist, or at least coexisting on the same album. Not only that, but I guess I've had a hard time deriving the same level of excitement out of this that some fans have been. Not that Inner Song doesn't have its merits and its highlights. There are absolute favorites for me on this thing, like the track Melt, which is an incredible, thumping, driving piece of tech house with swirling textures and chimey sound effects, trippy vocal delays, and an undeniable groove. Then Kelly Lee Owens' vocals, her whispery ice mantras, really embed themselves into my brain. There is also the track Night, which is another piece that has techno leanings. Kelly allows her breathy singing to play a more central role in the first leg of this one too. I won't go into the sounds as much as I'll say that I feel like I'm experiencing an electronic dance music dreamscape, where Kelly's gentle, echoed croons are pulling me deeper and deeper and deeper into a trance, with the beat slowly intensifying along the way and then eventually turning into this total tech house thumper, complete with a fat sustained bass line. Gung, 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 gung. Then after this drop, I love how quickly the bass, the percussion, all of it regains shape and tightness as essentially we move through a very strong final leg for this track with a few different passages to it. So these cuts are excellent. I love these tracks, but there's only a few like them on this record, I suppose because Kelly's talents also take her elsewhere, like the track Jeanette, which is a series of very bright nostalgic synth lines and throbbing beats that sound like they're straight out of an 80s video game or action movie. Aesthetically, it's not really in line with much else on the album, but I suppose it's good for what it is. The track does present some warm synth bass and hardened dance grooves in the final leg, though. There is also Line, L-I-N-E, Love Is Not Enough, which is a wondrous piece of ambient pop. There's a cool, sweet, subtle, endearing lead vocal, relaxing beat, layers of new-agey synths. Kelly's singing I found to be very expressive despite how quiet it was, and that Love Is Not Enough hook is very sharp, and the pre-chorus builds up the perfect amount of tension too. So there are some truly fantastic parts of this album that have me in awe of Kelly's ideas and wondering where she'll go next. But there were plenty of other moments on the record too where I felt kind of underwhelmed or even confused. The opening track Arpeggi is a cover of sorts of Radiohead's Weird Fishes, which is a gorgeous song, awesome track, heard a killer Leanne LaHavas cover of it earlier this year. But on this track, Kelly Lee Owens basically takes the amazing lead melody from that song, maps it onto an analog synth, then beyond that, there's not much to the cover outside of that melody. The progression and build she creates off of it isn't really that intriguing. The ending of the track left a lot to be desired too. Corner of My Sky, featuring John Cale, has some very rudimentary electronics serving as the foundation of the piece. Then Cale is woven into the piece with some accented surrealist poetry. There's something about it that makes me feel like I'm listening to a new Kraftwerk single. A new one, but not necessarily a great one. Cale is undeniably a legend, but his performance here isn't exactly stunning. He also becomes an afterthought on the track in a way, as the electronics he's surrounded in just increase in volume to the point where he gets almost buried. Then the whole thing turns into this very loud but tedious combination of new age music and techno. There are a few other cuts in the track list that I thought had likable qualities, but maybe they didn't go quite far enough. Flow is another piece of ambient tech with booming rhythms, good groove, but it is totally heavily lacking on the textural side of things. Progression-wise, the track runs across this very plain, upward scale of intensity. Listening to it get to where it's trying to go is like watching a second hand go all the way around a clock. Then the song On is another piece of ambient pop with subtle nods to IDM and Indietronica. To be completely honest, there's something about the song that kind of reminds me of the Postal Service. The cavernous reverb and vocal harmonies on the track are gorgeous, but there's not much else about it that comes off distinct or memorable. Then there's a really cool passage of tech house that the second half of the song ends up delivering that sounds good on its own, but the transition into that moment is quite awkward, as aesthetically and emotionally, these two different sections feel like they have so little to do with one another. This feels less like a formal song and more like something you would do if you were just kind of DJing two different tracks together during a set. So overall, I liked this. I liked a lot of the pieces and ideas that Kelly presented along these songs, but the listening experience of this album as a whole was kind of dampened by the lack of consistency. Feeling a light two decent six on this one, Tran. Zishan, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that up or the link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Kelly Lee Owens, Inner Song, Forever.